Hello, my name's Ollie Bray, and it's a great privilege of mine to be able to welcome you to this European SchoolNet Academy e-learning MOOC, which is on developing digital skills in your classroom. The course is structured around six modules, and the six modules are: what are digital skills and why do we need them? How to use digital resources and content, how to create digital resources and content, how to program machines, how to use social media, and module 6 will be a final project that we will ask you to submit and peer review. As you progress through the course, you'll have an opportunity to earn digital badges for each of the modules that you complete, and also a final digital badge at the end of the course. There'll also be an opportunity for you to submit your work for the eSkills for Jobs Awards in 2015. Throughout the course, we'll be uploading video content to YouTube. We'll encourage you to have discussions on Twitter and on the Facebook page using the hashtag eSkillsCourse. There's also, of course, an online forum and an online discussion forum that you can use as part of the course on the European SchoolNet Academy MOOC page. So let's get started with Module 1 so that you can understand a little bit more about what we're going to be looking at. Module 1 is called What Are Digital Skills and Why Do We Need Them? And this module is split into six parts. We've got an introduction, and I'll talk a little bit about what we'll be covering in a minute. What are digital skills? The future of work, the future of jobs, accessing jobs of the future, and future thinking. Let me just give you a little bit of taste in terms of what we're going to be looking at. In the next video, we'll start to actually look at what digital skills are and why they're important for children and young people, but also for teachers as well. We'll try and set this in the context of employment across the European Union and also global employment. In the next unit, we'll look at the future of work, and we'll try and think about what work might be like in 2020, 2030, 2040, and beyond. Of course, if we're thinking about the future of work, we also need to think about what jobs of the future might be like as well. And in the third part of this module, we'll talk to some of the industry experts and we'll get their opinion on what work might be like in the future. Of course, if we're actually trying to help young people to be prepared for jobs in the future, we need to be thinking about how they might access these future jobs as well and what skills might they need. It's all very well having digital skills, but increasingly, for example, young people will be interviewed for jobs via Skype and video conference, and their online presence will be increasingly important. We'll look at some of these key things during this part of the course. The last part of Unit 1 will be a bit about future thinking. I'll be introducing some technologies to you that already exist, but are only going to become more and more common over the next 10, 20, 30, or 50 years. These are technologies that I believe will change the way that we work, we play, and of course that we learn. So, throughout the course, can I just remind you again that we'll be setting questions, we'll be getting things for you to think about, we'll encourage you to have conversations online, and we'll occasionally set you tasks to complete as well. And there'll certainly be a task at the end of each module. But for now, what I want you to do is to get your brains in gear, to get yourself starting to think about what we're going to be doing during the course, get into that mode of collaboration with all of the other people that are participating across Europe, and most importantly, thinking about anything that you learn during this course, how can it have impact in your classroom? See you in the next video.